Starting there? Okay.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Happy Easter. Happy Easter. Amen. We're getting ready to get started with our praise and worship. Ask that you join in with us as we begin to sing praises to the Lord.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Hallelujah. You have won it all for me. Death could not hold you down. You are the risen King, seated in majesty. You are the risen King. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. You have won the victory. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. You have won it all for me. Death could not hold you down. You are the risen King, seated in majesty. You are the risen King.
Can we go back to the beginning and say, everybody say hallelujah,
hallelujah. You have won the victory.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah.
You have won the victory for me. Death could not hold you down. You are the risen King,
seated in majesty. Say,
seated in majesty. You are the risen King.
One more time from the beginning. Hallelujah, say.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory.
Death could not
hold you down. You are the risen King,
seated in majesty,
seated in majesty. You are the risen King.
Death
could not hold you down. You are the risen King,
seated
in majesty. You are the risen King.
Come on, sing it again. Say, death could not
hold you down. You are the risen King.
You are
the risen King.
Oh, hallelujah.
You have won it all for me. Death could not hold you down. You are the risen King, seated in majesty. You are the risen King.
Hallelujah. How many people are glad that God is risen? Jesus is risen. Hallelujah.
Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. He's my friend. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody
do me like Jesus.
Oh, he's my friend.
Sing it again, say,
can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody
do me like Jesus.
Oh, he's my friend.
He picked me up.
He picked me up.
And he
told me around.
Oh,
he picked me up.
Told me to run.
He turned me around.
Oh,
he picked me up.
Told me to run on.
Up
and
turn me around. He picked me up and turned me around.
Oh, he picked me up and he told me.
Turn me around.
He's my friend.
Can't nobody take nobody. Do me like Jesus.
Can't nobody.
Do me like the Lord. Can't nobody.
Do me like Jesus.
Oh, he's my friend.
Can't nobody say,
can't nobody
do me like you.
Do me like Jesus.
Oh, can't nobody do me like the Lord.
Do me like the Lord.
Oh, can't nobody
do me like Jesus. Do me like Jesus.
Oh, he's my friend.
Said he picked me up.
He picked me up and he
told me around.
He picked me up,
told me to run.
Turn me around.
Oh, he's my friend.
One more time, say,
he picked nobody.
Do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
Oh, can't nobody
do me like the Lord.
Do me like the Lord.
Oh, can't nobody
do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
Oh, he's my friend.
Oh, clap your hands in here, say.
One more time, say, can't nobody, say, can't nobody
do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord.
Can't nobody do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
He's my
friend.
Oh, he's my friend.
He's my
friend. Oh, he's my
friend. He's my friend.
One more time, say. How many people want to be a friend of God? How many people want to be a friend of God? Hallelujah. Bible says no greater love to have no man than this, than to lay down his life for a friend. Amen. And that's what today is all about, celebrating the life of Jesus, his resurrection. And how
Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love. Oh, oh. Sing and say, Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love.
Sing one more time. Jesus went.
Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love.
Oh, oh, oh.
That's love.
Come on. Y'all know the words. Help us sing it. So Jesus went.
Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love.
Oh,
that's love.
See, they hung him high.
They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head. For me, he died. That's love.
Oh.
That's love.
Sing it again. They hung him high.
They hung him high. They stretched him out. He hung his head. For me he died. That's love. That's love.
Let me go back to the top. Say, Jesus went. Everybody say,
Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love.
No greater love than this. Say,
that's love.
Jesus went, say,
Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love.
Oh,
that's love.
They hung him high, say,
they hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head. For me, he died. That's love.
Oh, oh, oh.
That's love.
Sing it again. They hung him high.
They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He paid his head for you.
Say,
that's love.
That's not how, say,
but
that's not how
the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again. That's love.
Oh, oh.
That's love.
Say, that's not how,
but that's not how the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again. That's love.
Oh, 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 oh. That's not how
the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again. That's love. That's love.
Jesus went.
Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love.
They hung him high.
They hung him high. They stretched him out. He hung his head. For me, he died. That's love. That's love.
One more time, say, they hung him high.
They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head. For me, he died. That's love. That's love.
That's not how.
But that's not how the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again. That's love. That's love.
Say it again. That's not how.
But that's not how the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again.
That's love.
That's love. That's love.
There's no greater love than this. That's love.
That's love.
Oh,
that's love. That's love.
Anybody know the love of Jesus? Sing and say,
that's love.
One more time.
That's love.
Come on, clap your hands. Give God the praise in this place. Hallelujah. I love you. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. I love you,
I love you, I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me
in such a
special way. That's why I praise you.
I lift you up
and I magnify your name.
Hey,
that's why my heart is filled with praise.
Sing it again. Hey, I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Lord,
today.
Because you care.
Because you care for me in such a special way.
That's why I praise you.
I lift you up
and I magnify your name.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Come on, if you know the words, help us sing it.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me in such a special way.
That's why I praise you.
I lift you up
and I magnify your name.
That's why my
my heart, say, my heart,
my mind,
my soul belongs to you.
You paid the price for me
way back on Calvary.
That's why I praise you.
I lift you up
and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Say, my heart,
my heart,
my mind,
my soul belongs to you.
You paid the price for me
way back in the Calvary.
That is why I praise you
and I lift you up
and I magnify your name.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Now hold on a second. I don't know if y'all know this, but this is not a concert. Just in case you didn't know, Nicki Minaj had a concert at Madison Square Garden last night, right? That ain't this. This is church. It's corporate singing together. Y'all got me rapping on the Sunday Easter morning. So let's try this again. Say, I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Lord. Come on, if you love the Lord, you should be singing.
Because you care for me in such a special way.
That's why I praise you.
I lift you up
and I magnify your name.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Come on, y'all can clap your hands on her. Say,
I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Lord,
today. Because you care.
Because you care for me
in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart, say my heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. You paid the price for me, way back on Calvary. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Say my heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. You paid the price for me, way back on Calvary. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. That's why my heart, that's why my heart is filled with praise. That is why, that's why my heart is filled with praise. Oh, that is why my heart is filled with praise. Anybody heart filled with praise? Say, that is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Oh, that is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
That's why my heart, that is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
That is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Anybody got heart filled with praise?
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
'Cause you died on Calvary, say that is why. That's why my heart is filled with praise. That is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise. Oh,
that is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
That is why.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
One more time.
That's why my heart is filled with praise.
Hallelujah.
The Lord, is your heart filled with praise? Hallelujah. Please stand for the call of worship. This is Resurrection Sunday. Amen. Out of darkness, of grief, and despair, comes a message of hope. Christ is risen. We run to the tomb to see ourselves and trust and it is true. Christ is risen. We hear a voice call your name, and we know our risen Lord is with us now and always. Everyone, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Thanks be to God. The Lord is in his holy temple.
The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him.
Ah. You may be seated. Prayer of invocation. O God, of our days, we come this morning with eager anticipation. We seek to know you, to see you, to touch you. Open our hearts that we might experience anew. Open our lives that we may be faithful witnesses to your resurrection. May we, with shouts of joy, proclaim our steadfast, liberating love to all people everywhere. Amen. Hear our prayer, O Lord.
Hear our prayer, O Lord.
Stand for the morning hymn, hymn number 187, He Lives. Thank you. Please stand for the affirmation of faith. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's but one true church, holy, apostolic, and universal in thought, whose faith we reverently and sincerely declare the use of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. Third day he rose from the dead, and he ascended into heaven, and he sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. Our scripture lesson is coming from Mark 16, 1 through 8, the New Revised Standard Version, updated edition. Mark 16, 1 through 8, the New Revised Standard Version, updated edition. The Resurrection of Jesus. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the tomb, which was very large, had already been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified? He has been risen. He is not here. Look, there is the place that he laid. But go, tell the disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out, and they fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. That is the reading of God's word, and God's word is blessed. Yes. Okay. It is prayer time. The altar is open for you to come lay down whatever you need to discuss with the Lord. Today is the perfect day because he's risen for you and me. So here is the altar. Come on down and have a talk with the Lord.
Whatever you need, God's got it. If you need more joy,
God's got it.
Anybody need joy?
If you need more joy,
God's got it. Say,
God's got it. If you need more joy, God's got it.
If you need more love, if you need more love, oh, God's got it. If you need more love, God's got it, say, God's got it.
If you need more love,
you got it. You continue to intercede for us, Lord Jesus. You got it. We are so thankful this morning that we got loved ones with us here this morning. Through it all, and in spite of it all, we all know that you got it because we have learned to trust in Jesus. We have learned to trust in you. Oh, yes, Father God, you keep telling us you got our backs. You got it. You got it this morning. You got it for us this morning, Lord Jesus, that we are so thankful.
Yes.
Father God, bless, Lord God, this woman of God, this angel, my angel, yes, Lord.
Yes.
She's my angel.
Yes,
I'm going to proclaim it this morning. She's my angel. The angel of this church. Yes, Lord.
Yes.
You got it. You had it when you present her to me. So, Father God, bless her. Bless her, Father. Bless her. Bless this angel of this church. From her head, Lord God, anoint her. Just like you anointed David. Anoint her from her head to her feet.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord Jesus. And every officer, every member of this great church, bless them, Father God. Bless each and every one who didn't think it robbery to stay in the house and stay in the bed and look at the Easter parade because they know that God had it for them.
Yes.
Oh, yes, Lord Jesus, we are so thankful. We are so thankful for the babies who are here, the babies who are coming, the babies who are out there. We are so thankful for the young people. Oh, yes, Lord God, we are so thankful because without the young, we have no church.
Yes, we
are so thankful this morning. Oh, yes, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we have so much to thank you for.
Yes.
Oh, yes, Lord God, be with us. Be with us this day, Lord God. Be with us, Lord God, as we walk the walk and we talk the talk. Lord Jesus, be with us. Oh, yes, Lord God, don't leave us. Because, Father God, we need you. We need you today. We need you tomorrow. We need you next week.
Lord.
We need you next month. We need you next year. Oh, Father God, oh, how we need you, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, we need you. We need you. We need you, Lord Jesus. We need you. Oh, yes, Father God, we thank you this morning. We thank you, Lord God, for this woman of God who's going to bring the word this morning. She's going to bring the resurrection sermon this morning. Bless her. Give her words to say, Lord Jesus. Give her what you need. Be with the organist. Be with each and every one that's here this morning. Father God, give them the desires of the heart, Lord Jesus. Because, Father God, you have a blessing for each and every one of us, Lord Jesus. Oh,
amen.
Father God, I thank you, Lord God. Oh, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
Because, Lord God, you know that I was sick. You know all about me, Lord Jesus, but you saw fit to raise me up out of the sick bed.
Thank you, God.
Oh,
thank
Father God, because you keep telling me.
Thank you,
you keep telling me
thank
that you,
you
got it.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Keep telling me to wait. You say, wait upon the Lord.
Yes,
Lord Jesus, that I'm waiting because you got it for me, Lord God. Oh, Father God, this morning I thank you. If I had 1,000 tongues this morning, I couldn't thank you enough for allowing me to step foot one more time in this great church. Oh, Father God, I thank you, Lord Jesus, I thank you. Father God, if I have left out anything, if I didn't say something, go to the hospital, go to the nursing home, go to the assisted living home, go to the homeless, go to those who don't know you, Lord God. Because, Father God, you got something for them also. Oh, yes, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. So, Father God, be with us, Lord Jesus. Be with us this day. Oh, yes, Lord, you got something special for us. Oh, Father God, we need you. Oh, yes, Lord, we need you. Oh, how we need you, Lord Jesus, we need you. We need you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Hey, God, in Jesus' name. Oh, yes, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Whatever you need, God's got it. Whatever you need, God's got it. Whatever you need more joy, if you need more joy,
God's got it. If you need more joy, God's got it. If you need more joy, God's got it.
Praise the Lord, because everybody's giving me signals. Y'all know I can't see. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm getting signals and waves, and I have no clue what y'all are telling me. Proceed with, okay, amen, after I done texted everybody in the world saying we were skipping that, okay? So, amen, amen. How y'all doing this morning? It is now afternoon. Amen. Amen. God is good. And all the time. Okay, y'all don't sound like God is good. Amen. Amen. Today is Resurrection Sunday. Some of y'all sound dead. Amen. Today is Resurrection Sunday. Amen. Amen. And as my mother, Reverend Norma Joseph, said, he got up. That should have made all y'all jump up and run him down the aisle. He got up. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. 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 All right. At this time, amen. I'm not going to act up today. At this time, we will have the True Worshippers Seeds of Praise Dance Ministry. Amen. Amen.
How many know God's a healer? Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5 says, "But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed." Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5, King James Version. You don't have to leave here like you came. God can heal.
We anticipate. to this building. You brought your burdens, brought your pain, but I have a message for you today. That when you leave here, it won't be the same. So you tell me you've been to your physician. Look at you, there's been no change in your condition. Reach out and touch the master's robe. There's healing for your mind, oh, your body and your soul. Oh, yes, there is. Hallelujah. God can heal.
God can heal.
Oh, yeah.
He can mend your brokenness.
But with every test and every trial, there is revelation that God is able to supply every one of your needs. He's here to touch you, heal you.
That you'll have your healing. Once God works a miracle to feed your needs, go tell them all. Oh, what you have received. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Father, it's Father. 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 stand and wait on the Lord and be of good courage. Because you said you strengthen my
heart. I have received.
Oh, I have received.
I have received.
Is there anybody in here can reach a hand to heaven? Right where you are. Come on and tell them.
I don't know about you, but we could do better than that. We could do better than that. But they say all the kids are in the street. They say that all the kids are doing something wrong. Yeah. Every time the praise dancers dance, whether it's the adults or the children, they bring me to tears each and every time. Amen. 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 I think it is time for the announcements. Amen. But since I'm already standing, amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Since I'm already standing, for those of you who may not know who I am, I'm the Reverend Denise L. Davenport. Amen. I am the pastor of the Caldwell Temple AME Zion Church, located in the Boogie Down Bronx. Amen. So if you are not in the building and you are in YouTube land, we are here every single Sunday on the corner of Reverend James Polite and Chisholm Street. Amen. Can't miss us. We got big red doors in the front. Amen. 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 So we welcome you. We welcome you once, as they say in the old church. Welcome you once. Welcome you twice. Welcome you in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I'm looking out, and I don't know whether you guys are visitors, or if you are a visitor, just wave your hand for me one time. All right. Amen. Amen to our visitors. I'm not going to make you stand up and say where you're from, where you do, what's your social security number, all that good stuff. I'm not going to do that to you today on this Resurrection Sunday. But once again, we welcome you into the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen. We welcome you to Caldwell. We are an imperfect people. I'm going to talk to this side. We are an imperfect people. There ain't nothing perfect about us. Amen. But we serve a perfect God. Amen. 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 We do not have a lot of announcements today. We've already. Amen. Reverend Joseph started praying before we could read who were on the sick and the shut-in list, the prayer list, amen. She just went right into praying, amen. So just so that you guys know, we are praying for Nadine Anderson, Joyce Bennett, Norma Virginia Bennett, Emily Brown, Essie Carrington, I spelt that wrong, Foster Colburn, Terry Farley, Rosalie Ford, Keisha Graham, Deborah McHugh, Christine Robinson, Mary E. Robinson, Basil Ross, Annie Ross, Reverend Beatrice Smith and Reverend James Smith, Michelle Williams, Sylvester Williams, and Betty Wells. Amen? Amen. 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 Daily prayer. We have daily prayer here on Monday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays at 5 a.m. and on Tuesdays at 9 a.m. and it is a dial-in, and I think it's on the screen, and it's also on your QR codes if you scan the QR codes. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. The only other announcement that we have is that we have a fundraiser going on, amen? And we are trying to raise, if you look around the building, you will see a whole lot of imperfections going on, amen? That we got crumbling walls and we have things leaking and this is a 100-year-old building, amen? Amen. Y'all ever dealt with a 100-year-old building? 100-year-old building got a lot of 100, it's like a 100-year-old person. Sometimes they got a lot of aches and pains and things they got to get. Well, that's what's happening in our building, amen? And so we are having this, we're trying to do a new thing to repair and revitalize our sacred space. We believe in God for $75,000. And again, you see it on your screen. I don't have to read it. It is also in your QR code if you scan the QR code. And those are all of our announcements for this morning. Amen. Amen. Once again, you know I can't see. Amen. I didn't know what that was. We have candy bags for the children. Amen. For Alpha Church. Amen. Amen. I know how y'all get when y'all get a little candy in you. Amen. 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 The adults too, they get the same way. Amen. So don't feel like it's only y'all. Give some sugar to these adults. They'll be bouncing off the walls too. Amen. Amen. So after service, there are candy bags for the kids. Amen. 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 Did I cover everything? Because y'all trying to do sign language knowing I can't see? Sister Norma is talking about Friday's Good Friday service. Amen. 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 Good Friday service. We call Good Friday service His Words, Her Voice. Seven dynamic preachers from across Zion, Westchester, New York City, Long Island. They all showed up and showed out. Amen. Amen. And then, because Alex thought I was rapping on Friday, we had fish and spaghetti. Yes, yes. I was not rapping. That was actually what we had. It was an awesome day, an awesome, I was exhausted when we left, and I didn't even preach. I was just tired because they had me crying from the first to the last preacher. Amen. And you know that crying wears you out. And that was all good. So I thank everybody who participated, everybody who did anything, everybody who worked in the kitchen, everybody. Amen? All right. Amen. 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 I even thank Chris. All right. he'll get it later. Amen. Amen. All right, this time is our time for the giving of our gifts, tithes, and offering. Amen. Y'all don't get quiet now. Giving of our gifts, tithes, and offerings. Amen. Amen. I know Mother Shaw and I'm going to say, Pastor, don't act up. It's Easter Sunday. This church is the only place where y'all think the lights stay on for a dollar. Amen. 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 Okay, I'm the only person saying amen is Mother Shaw. Amen. Con Edison bill is the same, whether you in an apartment, a house, a church, amen. And Con Edison don't care that you a church, that part. Amen. They will come with the quickness and cut our lights off, amen? Amen. So we ask that all those who can and will and are willing to give, give abundantly. Don't give out of necessity, give out of freedom, praise, and worship. Amen? Amen. 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 Maurice is going to give us some giving music. Amen. I'm not going to make it. Amen. Is Malia, Malia's, well, she's changing, so she can't be on duty. I got a whole lot of children in here. Where's Maya? Come on, Maya, and I don't know this young person's name. Oh, okay. I didn't see you, baby. Okay, I didn't know you was even here. Okay. If we'd all please stand. Starting from the rear of the church, my grandbaby Kai, she's gonna be with the dance ministry next year. And then my newest grandbaby, she'll be in the dance ministry the year after that. Please bring your gleaners. Where is my gleaner?
God is the joy and the strength of my life. He moves all pain, misery, and strife. Promise to keep me, never to leave me. Never, ever comes short of his word. I got to fast and pray, stay in the narrow way. Oh, live my life clean every day. I want to go with him. When he comes back, I've come too far, and I never turn. God is,
God is, God is, God is,
oh,
God
is, God is.
Joy and the strength of my life. He moves all pain, misery, and strife. He promised to keep
me, never to leave me.
They never, ever come short of his word. I got to fast and pray, stay in the narrow way. Live my life clean every day. I want to go with him when he comes back. Too far,
I've
come too far.
And I never
turn. Everybody say, God is,
God is, God is,
God is,
God is,
God is,
God is,
God is,
God is my.
Come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. seated. We thank you for your giving.
I am going to ask, Caldwell Choir to come on up. Hold on. Oh, it seems like we might have a praise report. Have a living miracle walking through the door. Come on, you ought to wave your hand and say, won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Hallelujah. Come on, God is good. God is good. To God be the glory, to God be the glory, to God be the glory.
He's dying for the things. He's dying for the things. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. For the things He's done. For the things He's done. For the things He's done. Yeah. For the things He's done. All the things He's done, He's done, He's done, He's done, hey, He's done, 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 oh, He's done.
So for those of you who may not know what's going on here this morning, that's what Resurrection Sunday looks like. That's what Resurrection Sunday is about. I was just talking to Winston last night. As I was talking to him, and I was like, okay, I got to get my mother in church. Amen. And we got to see how we're going to get Sister Carrington to church. And I left Winston in charge. I don't know what he did, how he did it, how it happened. But God is good. That's what resurrection looks like.
This is shouting time, Pastor. This is shouting time. Shouting time.
Yeah.
Remember what He's done for us from down through the years. Something to shout about. I've been there. From the manger to the cross. From the cross to the grave. But guess what? From the grave to the hero. We got proof. We got proof because He brought Essie back to us. Thank you.
Come on, choir, say,
Lord, do it. Lord.
Anybody need God to do it for you right now? Say,
Lord, do it.
Lord.
Lord, do it. Oh, Lord, do it. Do it for me right now. Do it for me right now.
Can we sing it again?
Lord, do it.
Come on, you ought to wave your hand if you need God to do something for you right now. Lord, do it. Hey, yeah.
Lord, do it for me. Lord, do it. Lord. Do it for me right now. You read the Bible. God knows you read the story about the blind man who could not see. But one day, we heard that Jesus was passing by. He said, lay your hands laid on me. And this is what he cried. He said, Lord, Lord. Anybody want God to do it for you? Say, Lord, do it. Lord, do it. Do it for me right now. You heard the story. God knows I know you heard that story. About a sick little lady named Miss Carrington. But one day, God let her come back into this church. We said, God, thank you for laying your hands, lay it on her. Everybody say, Lord, do it, hey. Lord, Lord, do it. Oh, Lord. Do it for me right now. Oh, oh. Do it for me right now. Right. Oh, I know you're able, Lord. Do it for me right now. Yes, you can. Do it for me right now. You want to wave your hand? If you know God can do it, stand, do it for me. Oh, right here, do it for me right now.
Do it for me.
Right?
Right now.
Now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Do it for me right now. my right now. God's right now. Yeah, that's where we get this whole thing confused. Amen, amen, amen. Our scripture has been read by our very own Sister Letitia Edwards, amen? Coming from Mark, the 16th chapter, the 1st through the 8th verses. And I'm going to just reread it. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" And when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. And as they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is a place they laid him. This is the place they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. Let's jump back up to 3. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" And when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. Just for a few moments, consider with me the subject, the stone, the stone. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you, God. We thank you for this moment, this day. We thank you for blessing us and how you just keep on blessing us. We ask right now, God, for you to hide Denise behind the cross so that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your Holy Spirit, activate. I need you right now, God. I need the words of my mouth to be acceptable in your sight, because you are my rock and my redeemer. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen, amen. Amen. Over the last several years, my thinking concerning Easter has become more and more simplified. I don't spend nearly as much time trying to understand, explain, or make sense of what happened. I'm more comfortable with accepting the story at face value. You know the story as well as I do. Jesus died on a cross. He was laid in a tomb. It was sealed. On the third day, the very large stone over the entrance was rolled back. Women go looking for the body. A messenger says, "He has been raised. He is not here. The tomb is empty and Christ is risen." I have no explanations for any of that. There's nothing on TV that's going to tell me how the stone moved, how Jesus was resurrected after he had died. Archaeologists can't figure it out. Scientists don't know how it happened. But I'm talking to somebody in this room that I've had experiences like that, where you can't just explain it because God just did it. I've seen it happen in my life, and I don't know about you, but I would assume it's happened in your lives. I read it everywhere in the scripture. Today's resurrection story isn't new. It's the pinnacle of what God has been doing all along. If you look at the Old Testament, you talk about Noah and Noah and the flood and the waters receding and then there being new life. That's resurrection. If we talk about the woman with the issue of blood who's been suffering for 12 years and she touches Jesus' hem and now she's made whole, that's resurrection. Have you ever been freed from some things that you've done in your life or were doing in your life, some patterns that took your, that diminished your life? Isn't that new life because you've been freed? Isn't that a retelling of the Israelites? Last night was the Ten Commandments. Escaping the bondage of Egypt? That's resurrection. Have you ever had new insights into your life, a new way of seeing the world, another person or yourself? You've been mad at Mary for a long time, and then something clicks, and for some reason you're not mad at her no more. That's resurrection. That's new life. Have you ever felt stuck and without energy or direction in life? Remember the lame man? And Jesus saying, stand up, take your mat, and walk? That's resurrection. What about Jesus' cleansing of the temple? Haven't there been times when you cleaned out and made a new start? I don't know about you, but I have, and that was, for me, resurrection. Have you ever felt the presence of a loved one who has passed on? You knew she or he was there. Maybe you spoke to them or heard their voice. That's resurrection. What about Lazarus? Unbind him and let him go, Jesus said. When has your life been unbound? When have you experienced a new freedom that released and enlarged your life? Think about a time when it felt as if a new life had been breathed into you. You felt a new sense of energy, enthusiasm, creativity, and everything was fresh and beautiful. Recall a friend who said or did exactly what you needed when you needed it. You were in a desolate place, and you hadn't asked for a thing, but they sent you some money in the mail, not knowing that you were broke and you had spent your last. Have you ever had a relationship that you were sure could not be salvaged? There was nothing left. The hurt was so deep, and the distance too wide, and then one day, a letter is sent, a phone call is made, or a conversation is started. Something changes, and the stone is rolled back. The sisters going to the tomb are having a conversation as they're going to the tomb, because, see, and men in the room, don't get upset with me. The men were hiding. It's in the Bible. That's what the Bible says. I didn't make that up. It said that the disciples are hiding in the upper room. I didn't write it. There are no women writers, as far as I know, in the Bible. But the women, even though he's been dead, and he's buried in this tomb, it is the women who get together and say, we're going to anoint his body. Because their love didn't stop. The women, no offense, wasn't scared. But as they walk towards the tomb, they're having this whole discussion because you know how we do, ladies. We don't always think the plan through. Amen? So as they got the spices, they got all that, they know what they're going to do. This is when they were thinking we really should have got one of the brothers, because how are we going to get this big rock from in front so we can get in and do what we have to do? Amen? Because, you know, we get a little ahead of ourselves sometimes. Yeah, we do. But the miracle of this is that they get there in the tomb, the stone is already moved. I don't know about you, but I've had moments in my life where large stones were removed. Yeah. Wasn't nothing that I did. I didn't even think about how I was going to get the stone removed. But somehow, God moved in that situation and moved the stone. Easter is not just about us looking back to see what Jesus did on the cross and in the tomb. Easter is about what has changed with you. Easter happens every year. Amen? Easter happens each and every year. It's not always the same time every year, but it happens every year. But what's different for you from last year to this year? What stones have been moved in your life? What stones are now no longer blocking you? Because it also says in that same text, the angel says to the women, he's going ahead of you. Remember I said that women, we get this thing about we get ahead of ourselves? But in this text, God says to the women, he's going ahead of you. Y'all missed that. He went ahead of them. Not only did he tell them to go, Mark is the only gospel that the women do not go and tell the men. They just going about their business. They're like, all the other gospels, the women, it's always the women that found them. That didn't change in any of the four gospels. But in the other gospels, the women go and tell the men. And then the men don't believe what the women are telling. They got to go see for themselves. That's one of my pet peeves with me and my husband. No offense. It's like when I say something salty, he now got to taste my food to see whether it's salty. But that's a whole nother sermon for another day. Amen? 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 So the men had to go and figure this thing out and say, well, maybe they're mistaken. Maybe the body fell off the table, or maybe the body did something else, or something happened. They had to go and check for themselves. Easter means many things for many Christians. For some of us, it's that once a year that we do go to church. For some of us, it's part of the trifecta. It's, what is it? Easter, Christmas, Mother's Day. I got that in the wrong order. Amen? Amen? Some of us is that. But some of us celebrate every Sunday. Some of us celebrate every time God wakens up, opens up our eyes. Every time, that's a resurrection moment. That when you go to sleep at night, your morning is not promised to you. That's resurrection. Do you realize that you celebrate the resurrection every single day? Every morning that he gives you new life, every single day that he gives you a new chance, every single day that he lets you do this thing that you call life one more time to get some things right. Who is stuck behind the stone? Are you stuck behind the big rock today? Today is the day for you to become unstuck. Today is a day, because not only does the stone mean that Jesus has risen, it also means that you are now free. Okay? I'll talk to this side. You are now free. The stone was blocking and keeping Jesus on the inside. Okay. You know what dawned on me last night? As I was making Easter baskets and trying to watch the Ten Commandments, as I sit there and go, that's wrong, that's wrong, that's not in the Bible, that's not in the Bible, that's not in the Bible, it dawned on me something. Something dawned on me. Y'all know Jesus didn't need them to move, didn't need to move the stone to get out. A couple chapters down, we got Jesus walking through walls, right? He walks in the walls. Okay. Jesus' moving of the stone was not for him. His moving of the stone was for you. He don't have to prove that he's resurrected. He could have left the stone there and just showed up. The stone was moved so that you would know he lives. In whatever your situation might be. I'm a Now y'all know I'm not a hooper, I'm not a holler. I don't jump. I can't do all that. Amen. Amen. Baskets. I need a basket. Good Friday. Jesus is on the cross. Good Friday. And when he was on the cross, we always start at the cross. We don't start at him getting to the cross. He had already been whipped. He had already been beaten. He was already bleeding. He was already bruised. He was already tore up by the time he got to the cross. So when he got to the cross and they nailed him to the cross, this is Dr. X. This is Letitia. This is my husband. This is your children. They were all nailed to the cross. It wasn't Jesus' sins, it was our sins that nailed to the cross. Broken relationships, it says. My health, it says, nailed to the cross. Confidants, nailed to the cross. My sister, nailed to the cross. I give my life to Jesus on the cross. Give me back my strength. It's on the... Oh, y'all not hearing me today. All of this is on the cross. All of this is on the cross. So when he rolled back the stone, he rolled back the stone so that you understand that whatever it is that you nailed to the cross... Whatever it is, you are free. And as they say, it's basura. It's garbage. It no longer exists. It's no longer part of your life. This is what Jesus is dying, and resurrection means today. Resurrection means that he got up. He got up out of the cross. He got up out of the tomb. The stone got rolled away. Why? Because John 3:16 says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. His only son. That's my only son. I would not give him up for near none of y'all. But God loved us so much that he gave us his only son. He rolled the stone back. He rolled that big old rock. And even though Peter's name was the rock wasn't around. The stone, I don't know why I'm trying to put shoes back on. The stone was rolled away. The stone was rolled away. Why? Because who is Jesus in your life? The Bible says in 1 Peter that he is a living stone. Oh, y'all didn't hear me. He is a living stone. He is the eternal life. He is everlasting Father. He is God all by himself. You see these lilies? It says that he is the lily of the valley. He is the bright and morning star. Who is Jesus in your life? Or are you still on the other side of the stone? God in the flesh. God Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah God all by himself. I don't know about you, but today, I'm happy that the stone got rolled away. And that he got up. And he didn't get up except for to prove it to you that he could get up. Because he could have just went on to be with his Father in glory. So he got up to prove it to you who he was. Because he's God all by himself. So I'm here today to tell somebody, if you think you're doing God a favor by showing up, you're not doing him no favors. He did you the favor when he let his son die on the cross for you. And even if you don't accept him today, he already accepted you. Amen. Everybody will stand to their feet. Amen. It's already 1:15. Amen. Because he lives.
God sent his son. They called him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy.
The doors of the church are now open.
Because he lives.
If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, if you have not opened up, removed the stone that's blocking your heart, we open the doors so that Jesus can come in and change some situations in your life. This first call is for those of you who don't know him as your Lord and Savior. The second call is for those who may know him as your Lord and Savior or has recently accepted him. The second call is for those of you who are looking for a house of worship to praise God in. As I said earlier, we are not a perfect church. We are an imperfect people, and we are an imperfect church. But we praise and worship and serve a perfect God. Once again, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and the second call is for those who may be looking for a church home.
Because he lives. How sweet to hold.
You may be seated.
A newborn baby. And feel the pride. And joy. Still
lives. I can face tomorrow because he lives. All my fear is gone because I know, oh, he holds the future and life is worth living just because he lives. And then one day I'll cross the river, I'll fight life's fight, the war with pain. And then as death gives way to victory, I'll see the lights of glory and I know he reigns because he lives. I can face tomorrow because he lives. All fear is gone because I know he holds the future and life is worth living just because he lives.
Can we sing it again?
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
Down my phone, so I don't even know if you responded. Okay. Amen. Please stand. Does everybody have communion elements? Amen. If you don't have, raise your hand and Sister Deborah will come and give you one real quick. Amen. 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 We're good. Dear ones, this isn't my table. It's not your table. It's not our table. But it's Christ's table. And because it's Christ's table, all of us are welcome here. At this table, you don't have to look a certain way. You don't have to worship a certain way. You don't have to look a certain way or love a certain way. You don't have to believe what I believe or what the person sitting next to you believes. You just have to come exactly as you are, seeking the one who is seeking you. So come, all of you, not because you must, but because you may, and here find healing and wholeness for your journey. You may be seated.
Let us pray together. Christ, who was there before the universe was called into creation, Christ, who was anticipated by the prophets and prepared for by the people, Christ, who was born in a manger, baptized in the Jordan, and who calmed storms on the Sea of Galilee, Christ, who fed us all with word, with healing, with loaves and fishes, Christ, who saved us with a cross and an empty tomb, Christ, who never faded, never abandoned, never truly left us, Christ of love, it is with you and because of you and in celebration of you that we gather around your table this morning. And gathered as we are, we pray, come Holy Spirit, come, consecrate this loaf and this fruit of the vine. Bless all of us in our eating and our drinking at this table, that our eyes may be open and that we may recognize the risen Christ in our midst and in each other, and be united with all of whom Christ died. Amen. And so we remember that on the morning of Jesus' resurrection, the women took spices that had been prepared and went to his tomb. And there they found that the stone had been rolled away and that his tomb was now empty. There they found two men with faces shining like lightning, who said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead?" There the women remembered Jesus' words that the Son of Man must be crucified and on the third day be raised again. And so this morning, we remember the story of Jesus' resurrection and the story leading up to it. And remembering this story, we gather around this table and we break bread and we pour wine and we are made whole. And we give thanks that everything Jesus did was for love and for us. Amen. Amen. If you will open the wafer side of your chalice. The body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which was given for us to preserve our souls and bodies unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in remembrance that Christ died for us, and feed on him in our heart by faith and with thanksgiving. You can flip your cup over. The blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ, which was shed for us to preserve our souls and bodies unto everlasting life. Drink this in remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for us and be thankful. With great joy this morning, I proclaim in Jesus' name that these are the gifts of God. For the people of God, come, for all things are ready. Christ, to this table we've come, to this table we've been fed. Because of this table we have been made whole. From this table we will sing your glory as Easter people, giving thanks for your saving love, and having prayed as you taught us to pray, all together, the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, amen. And I like to think that after they communed together, that they sang a song. I'm not even going to say a hymn. Amen. That they sang a song. And the song is, whatever Maurice says it is.
Do one verse of Yes, God is Real.
There are some things I may not know. There are some places I can't go. But I am sure of this one thing, that God is real, for I can feel Him deep within. Oh, everybody sing, yes, God is real, real in my soul. Oh, yes, God is real, for He has washed and made me whole. Oh, His love for me, yeah, it's like pure gold. Yes, God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul.
Pastor, can we sing it one more time?
Yes, God is real. Real in my soul. Oh, yes, God is real, for He has washed and made me whole. Yeah, His love for me is like pure gold. Yes, God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul.
Now, if all hearts and minds are satisfied, now unto Him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of His glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. And the people of God sing,
amen, amen, amen.
Now y'all go ahead and have the most amazing day. But if you can't have a good one, Sister Bernard, don't you dare go messing up nobody else's, you heard? Amen. Y'all could go, amen. Y'all want me to preach some more? I could do. Oh, my son. Wait. My son and his girlfriend are here with my next grandbaby. Come on, show everybody that baby bump. And my other daughter, Chena, and my son-in-love, and my oldest grandbaby. Kai is in the house. She ain't even paying me no mind today. Acknowledge my mother, the Reverend Norma Joseph. Don't forget to get the kids to get their candy bags as they leave. Notice I said as they leave. Amen.
It's stuck in my